Okay, is it working now? It totally didn't want to work for me. Here we go. Oh. Hi, everyone. I wonder how that looks on your end.
Resident
It did not look pretty on my end. My computer is
Zero.
freaking out because I dared to tab out of Resident Evil Zero. So welcome back to another Resident Evil Zero playthrough thing. If you remember from last time, we got split up. And then I got scared by bugs. That's pretty much all that happened. I think there wasn't really anything else too interesting. We have seen that they will play dirty, and that when you are split up, they will put new zombies in your path. So you can't just think that you're safe because, you know.
I'll go alone.
Okay.
Oh, damn it.
Let's regroup.
And here we go. Another episode of me not knowing the buttons. I need to play this twice a week. So I can get used to the buttons. So let's see. There's a lot of places to go. Let's just try going over here and seeing where that takes us. I don't know if that's where we went last time we got split up at. No, we went upstairs last time. So let's just kind of go over here and check out some of this stuff. Because we haven't really explored there yet. Be shotgun, Rebecca. And how does her inventory look? Okay, we got a Healy thing. Ooh, wait. Okay, let's go. Just three door. Ah! Buttons! Buttons! Again! Okay, this is the right door. So, we have to be on the watch out for them placing zombies where we've already killed zombies. Bugs. Slugs. Singing slug man. And see this? This is just dirty. He moved! He totally moved. Did you hear that? What's if I shoot? I hate that. Damn it. Rebecca! Okay. Here we go. Oh, and the cursor in the middle of the screen again. I think we have actually been to this one, but I don't think we went up the ladder. Yes, we've been in here. Right. I thought we've been in here. But there's, yeah, this. Let's go, Rebecca. I love these transition screens. I've heard people complain about them, but I just think they're so cool. Can you not? It's three of them. Oh, nope, wrong button. Okay, hold on. Let's give this to Billy so he has something. Also, I'm gonna give this to him too. I wasn't going to originally, but normally I send Rebecca out to do things on her own because she has the shotgun. So he can hold on to everything else. Okay, so that was a locked door. You know what? I can hide this cursor behind my head. See? Here's the cursor. Behind my head. Oh, this is upstairs. Okay, back downstairs. There are still things we were trying to do. See, what I love the most about this style, that it makes me really sad that you don't really see things too much like this anymore. Nothing that gives me the same feeling as, like, the first Resident Evil does, but I love having this big building full of locked doors and puzzles, and, like, you get puzzle pieces that you might not touch for, like, another few hours of gameplay, and I love that. I don't know if that's true yet with this, but I know at least in the first Resident Evil, like, you would get some things that you don't even really know what to do. You can miss stuff. There's just a lot of cool little things. And I feel like the kind of vibe that these games gave off just can't be replicated. Oh god, no. I don't want to go down there. Oh. First off. Second. And we're gonna go down there. Okay. But nothing just can recreate this vibe for me. Does that hurt? That hurts. So maybe I don't have to fuck with it? There's some literature on the wall. And I know that there are games with, like, a similar-ish style, but still nothing is good in my opinion. Nothing that I've played. First off, I love the aesthetic of mansions. I think that they carry a very cool aesthetic. And then when you consider, like, Resident Evil's aesthetic, like, it's a very ominous, evil mansion, and there's a whole bunch of, like, horrible, scary things in it. And they're terrifying. Sometimes they're not. Let's see. This is where we were before. We've been in this room. That was where the crows were. We've gone up here. We've been through here. Oh, there's a way right here we haven't explored because... Yeah. Yeah, okay. So let's go upstairs into this door. This is when Billy and Rebecca got separated. But it's like a big, spooky mansion and very, like, a certain style and aesthetic to it. And it's just full of things. And then you start to unravel that there's something bigger at play. Like, in the first Resident Evil, spoilers, sorry, you find out that it isn't just a spooky mansion. It's like, oh yeah, there's stuff up there. Okay, let's check out this room first. It's like a spooky mansion that has a reason for being spooky. Like, it was just like a cover-up for a lab. And that's why there's one bathroom. Ah! No. Are they dead? Dear God. Why? Who thought that was necessary? And how are you fine? Is Billy like that fake kind of find where it's like, you know, whenever my boyfriend's like, hey, what's up? And I'm like, you know that typical girl boyfriend thing? Sniff. No? I don't know why I'm expecting a response. I'm not streaming. But that typical thing where, like, a boyfriend will be like, hey, what's wrong? You're like, I'm fine. But you're not fine. Because they didn't buy you Taco Bell. Wow, these paintings aren't even packed in boxes. Water motif. And there's gun stuff here. You know, every time there's a Resident Evil game, I, like, never carry around the grenade launcher. Okay, let's go check in. Okay, let's go take our things back here. I think I have an idea of where the statue might go. I think it might go in this lady's hands. No. Oh, yes, yes, you. Never mind, I lied. Come here, Billy. No? But it's like a circle. Good and evil brought into balance. And there's the hot chick here. Yes, you liar! Okay, so I think then that other one, that gargoyle that we had, I think that one also goes in here. Yeah, because that one also has an oddly circular base. And let's make room for stuff. In case they get separated. And this thing's probably gonna go up here. Okay. So it's supposed to be when they're brought into balance, and they're obviously not in balance. But we're barking up the right bar stool. Let's go grab that other thing. Oh wait, there's a thing we had to do up here. Okay, Rebecca couldn't move this thing. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so they are forcing just Rebecca to go down here. Which means there's gonna be something scary. Okay, well this couldn't be any more obvious. I don't know why that looks more wrong than it should. What? What do you mean I can't drop it on it? Oh, no. Where are you going? Oh, you can still hurt me while you're hurting her? That's kind of BS. Ugh. That thing is disgusting. And it's stealing my waifu. Typical guys at anime cons be like, give me a hug. You can tell that they haven't showered in like weeks. Jeez, Rebecca, are you okay?
Are you alright?
Yes, thank you.
Remember that time that I said that this looked like a room for a boss fight, and then it was? Okay, how's our health looking? We're good! Then everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked. Only Rebecca, master of all four keys, could stop them. But when the world needed her most, she got picked up and dragged around by a giant bug thing. I don't think I can go down that anymore, can I? Okay,
I'll go check over there.
Nope.
This way.
Okay.
Buttons. Thank you. I wish I could remember. I think that door way over here, this one, I think that one said fire motif on it. So now we gotta play that game where we go test every single door in the area. Why don't I have a gun out? You know what, just take this. We have so much handgun ammo. Okay, and we know like that they like, yeah, we know that they like to throw new zombies in our way. Even better.
Ow!
You stop. Isn't there normally like a thing that these all come from? Nope, that's a clock. I thought that normally meant there's like a big one somewhere, right? Well, we're in the wrong place anyway. Let's go try the red door over here and see if that's any better. There is a new thing here though, so that's something, right? Well, we're leaving, Billy. Don't talk to me or my son ever again. Ooh, I'm actually starting to run out of time. Hmm.
I'll go.
Nope. Yeah. Wrong button.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Ooh, my health isn't looking too hot. Okay, we'll go try that door on the right. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't work, then we cry. Okay, so if it doesn't work, we'll end the video. If it works, we'll explore that area. I know somewhere was a fire motif. What did I tell you? Oh wait, that guy. That's a new guy. This one? Yeah! Okay, so let's explore this. Then once we're done here, then we'll save and call it for the day. What's that? Billy, you need that because you have a lighter. Hey, that means we can light that candle in the one room now. Wait, can he? Okay, awesome. Means he can hold more stuff for me. I don't like whenever they make it so eerily quiet like this. Is that it? I guess that lighter fluid is a way that we figure out that one puzzle with the candle, right? I just feel like there's probably something more in there. We also still have that grappling hook, which was used for, like, windows. So I wonder if they will do anything more with that. So what can we drop off? So much stuff. Oh, bless you, cat. My cat sneezed. Okay, let's pick up some ribbon. Okay, so we're gonna call it. We hit the 22-minute mark. And we're also finally gonna start saving over one. I like to keep 5 saves just in case something happens. So this is, you know, things are kind of looking up a little bit. I'm kind of getting more of that vibe I was talking about earlier with old Resident Evil. We fought that big boss thing. Things are a little bit too easy for me. I think when I first started playing, I might have chosen the easy difficulty because of how much I hate this. So when we beat it, maybe we'll have to, like, make it a stream thing to do it on a harder difficulty or something. Maybe that'll be something I'll do. So, anyway, other than that, this was pretty fun. We got to find a big thing, we got some more stuff, we have a piece to a puzzle. I like when you're kind of just wandering around and exploring places and you have all these locked doors and all these puzzles that you don't have the pieces to, and then all of a sudden something clicks. You get something that leads you to something else, that then just keeps leading you to other things. And it's just kind of, I really like that feeling. So we got the key, which then led us to that room, which then gave us the lighter fluid, which is gonna let us probably go into another room. I mean, that candle thing, I'll have to find what room it is again, but it was right by a door. So I'm sure we're gonna be able to light that now, which is really awesome. I'm super, super hyped. So things are starting to pick up and start rolling. It does feel a little too easy. That does make me sad. I don't know if I can change the difficulty mid-game. But, hey. What works, works. Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you so, so, so much. Remember to join me for the rest of this week. I think tomorrow I planned for a Kill It With Fire video. Don't know why I'm still doing that. But, remember to like, comment, subscribe. Join me on my Discord and all that kind of fun stuff. And other than that, have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching. Bye! Oh, if I can get the thing to stop.